to creativity. As parents and teachers, we tend to compare one child with another child. We tell the child, you and the neighboring child, both of you went to the same school, same tuition class, he got 95, you got 59. You are not creative. Look at that girl, she dances so well. You went to the dance school, you can't dance so well. You are not creative. We compare one child with another child. Remember, each of us is a wonder of the world. We are unique. I don't think any person in sane mind stood before Taj Mahal and said, I don't know why Taj Mahal is like this. It should have been like the Leaning Tower of Pisa. Or anybody stood before Leaning Tower of Pisa and said, I don't know why it is angular like this. It should have been very straight. Nobody ever said it. We accepted the wonders of the world as they are. Each human being is also a wonder of the world. By comparing one with another, yes, compare them in a positive way. Let the other child be a role model. Encourage it, but don't take it as a criticizing thing. Every time you compare, the child's creativity goes away. I had a student of mine in my college. When I was teaching the college students, one day my history professor came and told me, sir, we should do something to Manjula. What happened to Manjula? She's a second year student. She's so dull, sir. She cannot concentrate on the class. She is dreamy in the class. She is not interested in anything. Moment the bell rings, she goes back home. She has failed in the first year. She is bound to fail this year also. I do not believe that an 18-year-old cannot be good for anything. If somebody has survived 18 years, at least the spinal cord is strong. Then when 3-4 lecturers came and told me something to do with Manjula, something to Manjula, I called her to my chamber and asked, Manjula, how are you studying? She gave a typical answer and said, sir, I will do well in the final exam. I told, doesn't matter, I want to come to your house. I went to her house on appointed time. A small house. You can very well imagine the mind of this child. She had not done well in academics and the principal has come to her house. She was sure that I would be complaining to her parents. She had dedicated one ear and one eye only for my sake. I entered the house and saw all the walls of the hall were fully covered with extraordinary wall hangers, beautiful wall hangers. I had seen people keeping two or three to make the house look better. Out of curiosity, I asked the father, sir, who did all this? He said, sir, don't you know? Manjula did all this. I was so happy and I said, Manjula, before I could say la, she was there. And I said, child, I never knew you are so talented. Wonderful. Very well done. First time I saw a spark in her eyes, she smiled and said, one second, sir. She went into the room, pulled a huge trunk, which was full of more beautiful artifacts. I told her, Amma, don't open all this. I don't know how you bring it. Bring all of them to the college on Thursday afternoon. She brought all of them very unwillingly, very unwillingly. And I gave her the help of two attenders, arranged all these things in the auditorium, sent a small circular to the teachers and students. At 4:30, you are expected to go and see the solo work of Manjula. Believe me, at 5 o'clock, she was a celebrity. Till then, nobody thought she was worth anything. Even the strictest of the strict teachers went up to her and said, Manjula, how do you do that crochet work? How do you do that batik work? Can you teach me? She became teacher to her teachers. Something beautiful happened after that. Then nobody complained that Manjula is dreamy in the class. Teacher started telling, sir, Manjula is very good in the class. She is asking questions. You know what happened? If you see a leader talking on the stage and 10,000 people listening to him, whom are you watching? Do you watch the leader speaking or the fellow eating groundnut in the last row? Believe me, followers are never observed. Leaders are always observed. What leaders say becomes very important. Therefore, Manjula became a leader. Manjula became a leader. Therefore, everybody started watching her. Moment she became a leader, she had to stand up to the image of a leader. Image of a leader. Now Manjula performed well. Finally, she passed her final degree. And time passed. 10 years rolled on. One day I was sitting in my office. My secretary told me, sir, somebody has to come to see you. This Manjula walked in, very confident. Good in communication. She said, sir, I wanted to talk to you for a long time. I neither had the courage to tell you a time. I am in this place only for half a day. I said, where are you? Her answer shocked me. She said, I am the deputy secretary in the Ministry of Human Resource Development. I said, my God, what took you there? She said, sir, I knew that I was good in handicraft. When you told me to come and present in the school, I was really scared. When everybody appreciated, I got so much confidence. I went to Center of Designs, did a diploma, made a terracotta model. It was sent for international exhibition. I got the first prize and a chance of going to England, do a course in interior design. Then I went to the department as a training. I have traveled more than 70 countries on the globe, stayed in France, learned French and taught them Indian art. You know, she became the joint secretary later on. She told me, sir, the turning point in my life was the day you came home. I told child, mistake was not yours, mistake was mine. The door was here, but I was tapping it here. If I go on tapping here, the door will never open because the door is there. I told her, but the mistake was not yours, my mistake was mine. I was looking for your creativity in history, economics and sociology, but your creativity is in handicraft. You know what happened? Why this Manjula was not able to perform? Manjula's elder sister is a slightly better student. She used to get first class in the class. Her parents went on comparing with her. See, your sister is so good, she can get 60% marks, you can't do it. So this girl started feeling inferiority complex and said, I'm not as good as my sister. I'm not as good as my sister. Her performance affected. When she realized her talent, she became a very successful person. Comparison is wrong.